Good morning, students. Today we will start module 5 of IoT. In this lecture video, we will be studying the topics IoT physical devices and endpoints, Arduino UNO, and introduction to Arduino. So, introduction to Arduino. What is Arduino? Arduino is an open source electronic platform based on easy to use hardware and software. Arduino, it is a platform which is based on electronics sources and it is easy to use the hardware and software. Using Arduino, we can make many projects, combination of hardware and software, which makes the things more simple way. Arduino boards are able to read inputs from a light on a sensor, a finger on a button, or a Twitter message and turn it into an output, activating a motor, turning on an LED, publishing something online. Arduino boards, it reads the input of light. It can read the input from lights on the sensor, fingers on the button. It can read the input from the Twitter message and turn it into an output. And by reading the inputs, it turns into the output by activating a motor, turning on an LED, publishing something on online. So this is what the most amazing thing Arduino does, is by reading the things automatically. And based on that, it gives the output. So it can read the signal from the input, and it can turn on your LED bulb. It can activate your motor. It can read the Twitter message, and it can publish something on online or Twitter or something like that. So Arduino, it is a very amazing thing nowadays. Why Arduino? What is the advantages of Arduino? Why should we choose Arduino over another things? So first advantage of Arduino is it is inexpensive. Arduino boards are relatively inexpensive compared to other microcontroller platforms. So comparatively another microcontroller platform or hardware, Arduino is very, very cheap. The least expensive version of Arduino module can be assembled by hand. It is very simple, very cheap. It can be assembled by hand. Then second advantage is cross platform. So Arduino software runs on Windows, Macintosh, OS, and Linux. So Arduino software can run on many operating systems, which is the software to be portable on different platform. Next is simple, clear programming environment. The Arduino programming environment is easy to use for beginners, yet flexible enough for advanced users to take advantage of as well. The Arduino programming environment, it is easy to use for beginners. It is very easy to use for beginners. Even 10th standard students can also use the Arduino environment, and it is a flexible enough for advanced users to take advantage of as well. Even it is also flexible for advanced user to use it. Open source and extensible software. The Arduino software is published. It is open source and extensible software. Arduino software is published as one source tools available for extension by experienced programmers. The language can be expanded through C++ library. Open source and extensible hardware. The Arduino is based on Atmel Atmega microcontroller. This is one type of microcontroller which is used by the Arduino. Even relatively inexperienced users can build the breadboard version of the module in order to understand how it works and save money. So even on an inexperienced or graduation field, a person can also use this Arduino board because it is the simplicity and very friendly user. Now, Arduino UNO will be seen. Arduino UNO is a microcontroller board based on the Atmega 328 chipset. It has 14 digital input output pins, 6 Once again, we'll see Arduino UNO. It has a 14 digital pins, which we can see in the next diagram. Here, diagram is there. It is a 14 bit pin. It is there. 14 digital input output pins, of which 6 can be used for PWM outputs and 6 analog inputs. 60 megahertz quartz crystal, USB connection, a power jack, and ICSP header and a reset button. UNO means one in Italian and was chosen to mark the release of Arduino software. UNO means one in Italian and was chosen to mark the release of Arduino software. So UNO board and version 1.0 of Arduino software were the reference version of the Arduino, now evolved to near release. So let us see the Arduino UNO. So this is the diagram of Arduino UNO. Here some pins are there. You can see that it's starting from 0, 1, 2, 3. 30 meters one, and here one ground it is there. So this is the one is the reset pin. So all these pins have some functionality. Here ground pin is there, you can see that 14 is again a ground pin. Here A0, A1, A2, A3. By connecting all those things make some output. So let us see what all these numbers signifies. So first one, which is the reset button, you can see that what is its function. This will restart any code that is loaded to the Arduino board. So any code you have loaded and it has stuck, it is not working, then you can press this button, it will restart. Suppose pause has happened, something is hang, and then you want to restart, then you can press the first button. Then second button, it is AREF, that is second button, it is AEREF, that means it stands for analog reference. It stands for analog reference and is used to set an external reference voltage. Then third is ground pin. There are few ground pins on the Arduino and they all work the same. Here ground pins, we can see here, this is GND, third pin, it is a ground pin and it is connected with the ground. A ground pin, there are a few ground pins on the Arduino and they all work the same. Fourth one is digital input output pin. Here digital input output pin, that is 0 to 30. Digital input output pin, pins 0 to 13 can be used for the digital input or output pin. Digitally, anything you want to give the input, you can use these input pins, and you want to expect output, you can expect. Then fifth one is PWM.